Yo, Aguan, it's that guy. Good morning, not Nation. This is Not Locks, and today I'm giving you a dreadlock review of the basketball kind. So make sure you stay tuned, stay subscribed. This is Not Nation.
The Nation.
I was posting on Instagram the other day. If you haven't followed me on Instagram yet, I highly suggest sending on over there and linking me some pictures of your dreads. I'll post them up. But I came across this picture of a fellow named Tiger15, also known as Tiger Campbell, basketball player for UCLA, age 19. A lot of people saying he's looking like Black's hair, 6'Black". Saying he's got that same hair as Black. And a lot of people saying he's natty as fuck. And these dreads are definitely very inspirational, very legendary. And even though they're still in like that baby dread stage, these dreads are already very iconic. Now, possibly being a future basketball icon himself, he's made his hair pretty iconic already by bleaching one of these freeform locks just to make it stand out a little bit more. And in regards to his whole head, it is a freeform dread. And obviously we can tell this from a few factors. The way that his hair is kind of frizzing and balling up. We can also tell because the Congos, we can see how his dreads are joining up at the roots, making bigger locks. They're flatter. They have fish tails on the ends. We can even look and see a little bit of debris and lint built up in there. Looking over at Tiger's Instagram page, his locks definitely become, I like this photo here with the bandana that he's got going on. It really shows you the shape of his locks, and definitely down by the nape and the back of his head, the dreads are becoming really big and really flat. And if you look close enough, you can see that bleach blonde dread just kind of hanging out. This shot looking kind of crazy, reminding me of Curtis Williams, reminding me of Black, the headband kind of pushing his hair up and then the other part pushing down on the nape. A lot of volume happening here, and it's crazy to see how big his hair actually is in this photo compared to this photo, which means his hair has actually dropped quite a bit within the last year. Now, I did pull up some other pictures of Tiger here over the years. This would have been in the earlier stages, just before his hair was dropping. This was still a bit of a big afro stage. And notice how the front hairline here kind of has like a big dread of its own, just one big dread there. It's pretty much like the perfect dread fro that anyone could ask for. The way the dreads would form from this fro will definitely give him very iconic dreads. You don't actually see many people rocking hair like this. It actually reminds me of a lion's mane. This is more recently, we can see between the two pictures that his hair is starting to drop and separate around the crown here. It's starting to drop down by the sides, and this is when he's added the bleach. In action, he doesn't even need to tie his hair back when he plays ball. He just kind of lets it freely flow around, and this bleach blonde dread almost looks like a flame. Pretty crazy. I really like the way that his dreads are growing. Definitely very legendary already. I wonder how he feels playing UCLA with his hair up like this. Now you can see that he is sweating quite a bit. He'll probably need to rinse that out after each performance. This photo here, earlier stages, and his fro is pretty uneven at this point, but notice how it actually grew in pretty even over time. So it's basically just the awkward stage, and everyone needs to embrace this awkward stage on their dreadlocks when they're going through it, because it doesn't last forever, so you don't have to feel self-conscious at all actually when you're in that stage. So pretty cool that he's actually got a little bit of color in there. He didn't go too overboard on it. Picture with his headband pushing him up just slightly. Dope looking afro. It's actually pretty great the amount of action shots that we get with his hair flying all over the place while he's playing ball. Early stages of his dread fro. So it looks like he could have been growing this at least about 3 years or so. Here's a great shot showing you his baby dreads and how they've combined. There's even a little bit of webbing happening up there, so he's not even separating. He's just letting it freeform completely. And I like how in his younger days, he was still rocking the sweatbands and just letting them grow in on their own really early stages of the dread fro. And this is while he was in seventh grade. And that's cool to see that kids growing their hair out in high school these days, because definitely when I was in high school, you grow your hair like this, you get a lot of shit on your name, stereotypes and assumptions. Here we go, really, really early stages of the dread fro here. So this is basically where he started from to what we see he's at now. So it's quite impressive. I'm gonna end this video here. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this one on Tyga Campbell, and I'll definitely see you guys in the next dreadlock update. So until next time, peace out, one love, stay happy and natty, and grow out those dread fros. I'm gone. Adios.